Sauce Down is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The Golden Eagles have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 33-yard line. Fires out quick. It's picked off. That's a great tackle at the 37. Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
From the 13-yard line, it's first down. He's on the run, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
It's third down and seven to go. Ball on the 10-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw.
The offense gets a first down here. You got to give them some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense to third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on a quarterback, especially when they're passing the football, and try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
Tackle at the one-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and goal.
It's second and goal. Ball on the one-yard line. They put everyone up on the line. On the handoff, big hit, and he'll lose yardage.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That makes it third and goal.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And they're in. Touchdown.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
And he converts the extra point. So that's a 7-play, 37-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. So our score, 7-0. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the 9. Brought down at the 31. One team forced to punt, Herbie, and the other one comes right back and gets some points.
Boy, Brad, this is exactly how you draw it up. You come up with a big stop to start the game off. Your offense moves down, gets points on the board. You can't start much better than this.
The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
Well, they're already playing from behind the eight ball, but they have plenty of time to get back in this thing.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. It's second and nine. Ball on their own 32. Big opening. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He's taken down at the 45. From their own 45-yard line. Second down. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That makes it third and three.
The halfback with a carry. And he's taken down at the 42.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
From the 42-yard line, first down. The halfback picks up a yard. Catch, first down, and he's knocked out. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. And he's level at the 18-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. The 10. He's got it out to his tight end, and he tackles him hard at the 8.
Number 8 on the tackle.
First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks.
First and goal.
And they make the stop right around the 2-yard line. They fake the handoff and complete the pass. Good for 6 yards.
Tight end does a good job here of selling his block and then getting out on his route and then making a nice catch for a good game.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 7-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. And it pays off. Touchdown.
From a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 36. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. 32-yard line.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
Second down, 14 coming up here.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. Tackle at the 28-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a Dina 4 run there. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go.
Ball on the 32.
They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. Oh, excellent punt. They'll bring him down at the 19-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
He's out to the 30, and he's tackled
around the 32-yard line. From their own 32-yard line, first down.
Down at the 34-yard line.
Gaining 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
It's the sophomore that's got it.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on their own 43.
Makes it to the 37.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
The 37-yard line. It's first down. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
The offense calls a timeout.
And he hits him hard at the 49.
Loss of 9 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27.
toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Booming kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Now we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break eventually could be the team that wins it.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
And he throws it away.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. They lose four there.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Hands it off. Runs outside for a nice game.
You're not going to catch this defense napping very often. They were clearly ready for that run.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Gets to about the 37-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
He's out of bounds
at about the 43-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Zips it to the back. Tackle made around the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 30 inches.
Passes it to the middle of the field. Tackle right around the 42-yard line. Makes the catch and look out. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Spikes the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Just throws this one away.
Change of quarterback, Herbie. You got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Here's a quick throw. Incomplete. Almost picked off. That was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. It's up. Looks long enough. And he nails the long field goal. They're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Golden Eagles
struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game. And sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play. One touch to get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number one on the intended receiver on the way.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there, and one of his guys can come down with it. He's wrapped up for the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
And they got him. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 10-7.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Neither ground game very productive in that first half, David, and I really think it came down to each player on the defensive side executing their assignments and trying to get the positive self-determination that they wanted from a defense.
No doubt about it. And you look at the defense is doing such a great job stopping the run. That's the first thing that you do 99% of the time in meetings is, what are we going to do first? Stop the run. Because that's usually the place where you can get gashed the most. It's the simplest. Quarterbacks don't have to go back and make reads. It's designed. You know what they're going to do. But it also comes down to the big boys up front and those big boys making holes. And right now, I don't see many holes. And I don't care if you have Barry Sanders. I don't care if you have the best running back of all time, whoever it is in your backfield. If there's not a hole, there's no yards to be made. There's nothing they can do. So the defensive line doing a great job stuffing the run.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. We're going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. And down he goes at the 27. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards.
Second and seven. From their own 30-yard line. Second down. And they get nice yardage on that run. 5 yards there for the quarterback. His way to about the 45. From their own 45-yard line. First down. He makes his way to about the 42. From the 38-yard line, it's second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none.
That'll make it third and one.
He's taken down at the 33-yard line, and they'll still be a little short of the first down line.
Well, they get some positive yards, but this defensive line really busted through and broke that play up.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Brought down after a nice run up the middle, and that's That's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Taken down at about the 19-yard line. Tenth play of the drive.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that, going to the meetings the other day, is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
He gets out to about the 11-yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. From the 6-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
And this is the 14th play of the drive. Throws it away. They've got one fourth down conversion on this drive. Now they'll give it another go. They put everyone up on the line. Touchdown.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
You know, sometimes you see defenses play good in stretches. This has been the longest stretch I've seen one defense play in a football game in a long time.
Yeah, I think the consistency is the thing that stands out. I think they got off to a great start. At halftime, they made a few adjustments, and they've come out even played better, believe it or not, here in this second half.
What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play, and you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
From their own 36-yard line. First down. He fires.
This is a well-prepared defense. They know where to be, and they know what their opponent likes to do. They play tight coverage as well.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. He goes out of bounds around the 41-yard line. He fights forward to about the 40. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Mike four, Mike
takes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The Golden Eagles had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. And he's leveled at the 36-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 17-7. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. There he goes, to the 10. The ball pops free, and no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds.
The ball just kept scooting all over the place on the sideline, and it finally skipped out of bounds before anybody could claim it.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. And it pays off. Touchdown. Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback.
Kirk, I got to ask you, are these two offenses that anemic or are the defenses that good?
I think it's a combination of both. I think both of these offenses have shown at times an ability to execute and put points on the board, but they're playing against two really good defenses.
So early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. He laterals. Nice run there as they work the outside. The stop at the 47. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. They go with a run, and he brought down in the backfield. Here's the pitch, left side. Brought down around the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line. First down. Good protection, and now he's on the run. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
Number 86 was the intended receiver.
From the 42-yard line, it's second down. Just under two to go in the game. They'll knock him down for a loss.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
That's a great tackle at the 42. Golden Eagles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The Golden Eagles have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Here's the tight end. Drops.
Terrific coverage. And when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
And he's tackled at the 32.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
Throws it in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds at the 40-yard line. And he stops the clock with a spike.
Third down.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires out to his wideout.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
A little over a minute in the game. He gets rid of this one. From the 48-yard line, second down. Fires out to his receiver.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. And they push him out at the 32-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he just gets rid of it. This is the 10th play of this drive. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Well, the kicker is on here, and if this goes, we've got a tie ball game. If not, this one's in the books. Kicks away, and he got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game. And poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
We have less than a minute to go.
It's a fumble. It's picked up by the defense. Tackle made at the 40.
What a huge time to lose the football.
Yeah, you can't cough it up late in a tie ball game like this. If they end up losing because of that fumble, this poor guy is going to be looked at as the GOAT.
We're late in the fourth quarter. Great game. A tied football game. And the question now is, who's going to rise to the occasion?
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled.
Around the 32-yard line.
Number 32 on the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it second and two.
Throws out, and a leaping interception by the corner. And he tackles him hard at the 15.
It was time for somebody to step up and make a play. And boy, did the defense come through. Now they've got a chance to take the lead. That was huge.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 15. Get on the throw. He caught it. Tackle at the 12. The offense calls a timeout.
Was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
From their own 12-yard line, it's third down. Well, the player of the game might come from the defense after that stop here late in the fourth quarter. That could be the turning point.
That makes it fourth and long.
Dangerous area to punt out of here. Let's see if they bring the heat.
Well, we've had fun, folks, but we're not done yet because this game is heading to overtime. And we're back ready now for overtime.
Receiver's got the first down, and down he goes at the 8-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Five wide. Hit immediately.
And he gets the touchdown. Hits the PAT. It's first and 10. Ball on the 25. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
First and goal.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Loss of two on the toss play. Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 4-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. And he catches it off the tip.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 30 goal.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Well, it's going to take another round at least. You can bet the coaches are going to look to be more aggressive on both sides of the ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Got a man tackled for a loss. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
But that play was sort of out of sync from the start. But you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Some ground. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. And they got it.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. It seems like they almost saved their extra pass rush, an extra incentive as far as their energy, when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
And that's 3 and out. Nothing going on that series. From the 25-yard line, first down. Throws in the middle. He's taken down around the 21-yard line.
That makes it second and 6.
From the 21-yard line, it's second down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
That's a gain of 5 on the right. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Taken down at about the 13. From the 13-yard line, it's first down.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
Second and 7. Ball on the 10-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
That'll bring up 3rd and
Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. They'll bring him down at the 2. First and goal from the 2. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. And he is drilled at the 4-yard line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
Mike Ford.
They come out on an empty backfield. Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown.
I'd give the game ball to the whole defense. Their performance in the first series of the second overtime was just huge. Allowing 0 points in the second overtime really made things easier for their offense.
Golden Eagles, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. Next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
Well, that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Dirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.